Today we're going to be talking a little bit about 10 worst starting rooms for Call of Duty Zombies, and we got some that are unthinkable, some are pure garbage, some are trash, and some are unbelievably nastiest rooms I have ever seen in my whole goddamn life. And this video may get you triggered temporarily for a longer and extended period of time, so don't risk it. Find a solution real quick to combat it. It can occur at any given time. Maybe right now you're happy, but hey, all of a sudden you're gonna drop down and you'll be triggered. God forbids, but you will feel like punching someone in the face, and that's a big no-no. My best advice is that you put something on, probably and preferably a helmet, on top of your forehead. Gotta let that shit chill out, you know what I'm saying? But hey, that's just me, right? That's kind of like my two cents. But anyways, guys, like, comment, subscribe. I don't care anymore. But hey, coming in at our number 10 spot, we're talking about 5. Now, trust me, 5 is one of my favorite map, but at the same time, it is not my favorite map, if you know what I'm saying. But ladies and gentlemen, I got a friend named Bob, right? If you didn't know, Bob is one of my homeboy, and he's someone that just started playing Call of Duty Zombies, and he was playing this thing called Call of Duty Zombies, like I said, and he was like, yo, I want to be able to play something new. And I was like, yo, Bob, have you played this map called 5? And he was like, yo, I haven't played, just load me in. I was like, okay, Bob, just come on, I'm gonna let you play this map, right? He loaded in. Bob loaded into 5. Bob was playing the map, and guess what? Round 1, my boy just died. My boy just went down. And the thing is, starting room is basically everything. And starting room deteriorate your luck. And it's very important you understand this, alright? 5 has a beautiful concept. I love this map visually. But hey, the starting room, it's not a dank meme to Bob, nor to me, nor it should be to you as well. But ladies and gentlemen, if you're getting triggered, just know this is a video about a video game. That's exactly how I give people hope. It's not gonna last for longer. That's how I give myself hope as well, because I feel like punching someone right now as well. But ladies and gentlemen, coming in at our number 9 spot, we're talking about this map by the name of Shinonuma. I don't even know why I do this, but hey, like I said, at our number 9 spot, we're talking about Shinonuma. Now, Shinonuma was the original map. Doesn't matter. The fact of the matter is, we got it back in Black Ops 3 Zombies with this thing called Zombies Chronicles, right? AKA DLT 5 confirmed. You know, I love those days. I miss those days. But hey, Shinonuma is definitely one of the pure garbage. I mean, it has a pure garbage of a starting room. The only good thing about this map, which is not even a good thing, like, let me just say this, Peter McKinn, my boy Peter, right? That's only the good thing about this map. But at the same time, that is not a good thing about this map, because hey, surprise, he's just hanging, right? My boy is dead, right? So I mean, like, rest in peace to Peter McKinn, you'll be forever missed. But you know what I'm saying, it's probably one of the best, but at the same time, it's not one of the best. And trust me, Shinonuma, I love this map. It has everything, but at the same time, it doesn't have everything, if you know what I'm saying. But ladies and gentlemen, what I'm trying to say, the starting room is not the very best, meaning it's not good. That's what I'm trying to say. And you got like RK5, Shiva. You also got the Gobblegum machine. Basically, that's pretty much about it. You're gonna get in that, you're gonna kill some zombies, and surprisingly, they're gonna kill you, basically. So that's the thing that's gonna happen to you by the end of the day. And Bob, trust me, he doesn't like that. But at our number 8 spot, we're talking about a map that is so hated in the Zombies community, and I feel like this map is a little bit loved by Bob, and everything that is loved by Bob, I like to kind of like show my appreciation. I like to show some respect. I should like to show some love back, if you know what I'm saying. But ladies and gentlemen, we're talking about Transit. Now, I know what you're thinking. You're like, Skizzle, like, seriously? I thought I'll get triggered, like, probably by the end of this video, but I'm getting triggered right now. You need to stop. But trust me, guys, just know this is a video about a video game. Stay hopeful, this is gonna be over soon, so don't get triggered. It's just a video about a video game, like I said. But ladies and gentlemen, Transit is probably not the worst map, but it definitely has that worst starting room. It's like you're trapped in here, you got 3 parts, zombies are sleeping, you walk, they are vague. Like, what, you crazy? But hey, this is how Jimmy Zielinski made this map. I feel like it was Jimmy Zielinski. I'm not totally sure. I don't want to go around and Google shit, but what I'm trying to say, Transit has definitely one of the memeiest starting room ever in the history of this thing called Call of Duty Zombies, and that's basically what's up. But at our number 7 spot, we have Dire Rise. Now, Dire Rise is a map, basically you got buildings and you got more buildings, basically. That's what this map consists of. Zombies spawn everywhere, there is a spawn to the left, there's a spawn to the right, and it's not a dank meme. You're trying to like train zombies here, but you can never do that, and it seriously is not a good meme. But coming in at our number 6 spot, now Embrace Yourself, I'm gonna give you a trigger warning real quick, because we're talking about a map that is dear to my heart, and that is dear to a lot of people's heart, and I don't wanna do anything bad. I just wanna give you a warning real quick, trigger warning. I guess I did my job here. But at our number 6 spot, ladies and gentlemen, we're talking about the Eisenthrall. Now, a lot of people love this map, I love this map. The starting room is visually pleasing, but in terms of gameplay aspect, it is pure garbage. I mean, gobblegums can definitely and for surely help, but at the same time, they cannot like help you fully. That's what I'm trying to say. It looks visually clean, it looks visually pleasing, but Papa Panzer can spawn in at any time, or I mean, just say like he's gonna spawn on a specific round, but at the same time, he will spawn in. That's what I'm trying to say. And when he spawns in, what you're gonna do? You're probably gonna get a death machine, but what if you don't have that gobblegum? What if you have that gobblegum but you don't get it out of the gobblegum machine? Then what, right? Then what? And another thing is that, yo, you got a friend named Bob, and Bob doesn't understand shit. He's like, yo, I'ma play this map, I wanna get you around 100. He got goals like he wanna reach stars, but at the same time he knows that but hey, what I'm trying to say here is that you cannot properly train in here, and it is seriously not a dank meme to anyone. But hey, at our number 5 spot, Embrace Yourself once again, and we're talking about Buried, one of the shittiest map, or I mean to say one of the shittiest map with a shittiest starting room, or a shittiest starting room. The map is good, but not like I effed it up. But ladies and gentlemen, it has one of the garbage starting room ever. It looks visually pleasing. Once again, it has all that sort of like whatever, it doesn't matter, right? But at the same time, you cannot train, and this area sucks dicks. I mean, you got the L set in the starting room of Buried, and that's probably the dankest part about the starting room of Buried, right? But hey, surprise, check this out. You're gonna jump on the ledge, you're gonna hope that you can purchase the L-set, which you're gonna do. You're gonna be able to buy the L-set, but guess what? Then you're gonna fall down and you're gonna leave the starting room, and it's just gonna be game over. You're gonna fall down and you're gonna get into this sort of like sub starting room. That's what I like to call the second starting room of Buried, but it's not starting room. So I mean, it's like Buried has definitely the worst starting room in terms of gameplay aspect, but hey, in terms of visual, it is a good meme. But at our number 4 spot, ladies and gentlemen, we're talking about Gorak Krovi. If you're getting triggered, just know it's a video about a video game. Stay hopeful, it's gonna be over pretty soon. That's how I kind of like give myself hope as well. So I'm just like, hey, I'm gonna give y'all hope. But Gorak Krovi, one of the best map, that's all I gotta say. But the starting room is pure. It looks good. We got dragons, we got some Margarita, we got RK5, and that's pretty much about it. That's it. But hey, the thing is, the starting room doesn't really have that training factor. You cannot train properly here after round 7, right? And hey, surprisingly, you're gonna get dragons come here and they're gonna breathe fire. Gorak Krovi, 10 out of 10. Gorak Krovi starting room, -10 out of 10. But at our number 3 spot, ladies and gentlemen, coming in with another banger, and this one was like a hard decision, right? I kind of like, I had to flex, I needed to kind of like burn a lot of million individual brain cells. You know how that shit goes, right? Lost a lot of brain cells, but hey, I just came to conclusion that at our number 3 spot, we're gonna have Zetsubou no Shima. I wanted to kind of like have Origins starting room. Origins, probably one of the best zombies map ever. Visuals are absolutely insane in the starting room, but the thing is, with Origins, if you know how to play, you can actually get a SMG, fully pack punch, you can also get double tap, you can also have the quick revive, you can also have gobblegums, and you're gonna fly basically if you know how to play. But in Zetsubou no Shima, Zetsubou no Shima is pure AIDS. It's garbage. It's like, these words don't even describe the map. I mean, if you're getting triggered, just know this is a video about a video game, so stay hopeful. I mean, this is gonna be over soon. Zetsubou no Shima, a lot of people hate it, but a lot of people love it. I personally don't like this map, but at the same time, I like this map, if you know what I'm saying. That's exactly what I'm saying, but we're talking about solely starting rooms. Now, you got a lot of water. Number one, water is not wet. A lot of people say it's wet, but hey, if you say that, trust me, you're dead to me. Water is not wet, and that's a fact. Even when you go around Google and say, is water wet? Google gonna tell you it's not wet. So basically, I believe in the Googles and everything like that. But hey, what I'm trying to say, you got water, you can train there, but if you have no perks, you're not gonna be able to train properly. And even if you got all the perks, even if you say, hey, it's good luck and pop Perkaholic, well, with Perkaholic, you're gonna get Vito's Wine, and surprisingly, when you're training underwater or on water or when you're swimming right, you're gonna hit zombies, they're gonna get that Vito's Wine effect, they're gonna stuck there or they're gonna stay there, and guess what? They're gonna come back, they're gonna hit your ass, and your ass gonna go down, and that is not a good meme. Trust me, listen to me right now, that is not a good meme, and Bob absolutely hates that. Bob actually played this map called Zetsubou no Shima, right? Just like a couple of hours ago, and he was saying, yo, this is not a dank meme, and I was like, yo, I told you, man, and that is not even the fun and juicy part. You get Thrasher spawning in like there's no tomorrow, even when you have like zero perks, and on top, you don't even have quick revive in the starting room, and it's just not, like, seriously, guys, if you can do something, trust me, say no more Zetsubou no Shima. But coming in at our number two spot, I'm talking about Viruk. Now, Viruk, it's not a good meme. That's exactly what you thought, but hey, you're wrong. Viruk is a beautiful meme in this map, or I mean, in this game. I love this map. This map is just absolutely love it, but at the same time, I don't fully love it, if you get what I'm saying. But Viruk, okay, so basically you can spawn, or you can either spawn in this area where you get Juggernaut, or you can spawn on the other side where you get Quick Revive. If you spawn in the, or where Quick Revive is, basically you're gonna be able to buy Quick Revive, and basically that's it. You're gonna buy Quick Revive. Round 2, you're gonna go down, you're gonna buy Quick Revive once again. Maybe if you got luck, you're gonna be able to get to round 10, but that's pretty much about it in that starting room. Like, you got nothing, basically. But if you spawn in this area, well, you got Juggernaut, but surprise, you need to turn on the power in order to get Juggernaut, and I mean, it's just, you know what I'm saying, right? But coming in at our number one spot, now this one has probably the worst, the garbage, the trashiest, it's not even a word, but yeah, you know what I'm saying, this starting room is not a good meme. A lot of people died in here. It's just not, it's not good, guys. Trust me, you don't even want to hear. I guess I want to end the video. Now, coming in at our number one spot, we're talking about Shadows of Evil, and this area is tighter than the Bumhole. That's exactly how I like to describe it, and Bob agrees with me, Carlos agrees with me, everyone agrees with me. Yeah, let's just say that everyone agrees with me. But check out some other videos on the screen. Subscribe if you're new. Let me know what is your favorite and worst starting room in the history of Call of Duty Zombies. Let's use all those fancy words, but hey, I'll see you very freaking soon.